I love jumping to the root of problems. It saves so much time. In order to know God and find God and get closer to God, you must think about God day and night. Period. I've just summarized the current status of everyone's position on this planet before God. It is directly linked to how often they think about God and how much they understand that everything belongs to God, is for God, and from God. God knows your thoughts. He knows every one of them. He knows what you think about all day long. He knows what you watch with your eyes, what you hear with your ears, what you record with your life, and what you decide to do every single day. He knows it all. He knows every human worldwide. Doesn't matter what language you speak. He knows your thoughts. He knows what you're after. He knows what you're chasing. He knows what you want. He knows what your goals are. He knows how often you think about him. He knows how much you desire him. He knows. And I kid you not, he actually has everyone arranged in a giant database in his mind, knowing how much each individual human on earth thinks about him and values him. It's true. It's true. And Jesus said, by their fruits you will know them. You know, you can tell how much someone thinks about God by how much they talk about him, and how much they have to say about him, and how much they know about him, and how much they've heard from him. You can pick TED Talk after TED Talk. You can pick CEO after CEO all across America, and they never talk about God. Why? Because they don't know him. And they never hear anything from him. Why? Because they never think about him. They don't desire him. They don't believe in him. They don't want him. It's a serious epidemic, but it's real. I'm here to jump straight to the kisser, as always, to save the most people the most time and the most frustration. Your thought life, and what percentage of it is spent desiring God. Your heart, and what percentage of it is desiring God above everything else in the universe, directly determines who you are, where your life is, where you sit in the mind of God, and therefore what your success level is in the universe. Because the level to which you please God in this life is the level to which you are successful. Because that is the meaning of life. That is the goal of life, is to bring God maximum pleasure. Period. Okay? And you need to hear from God. You need to get feedback from God on what does and does not bring him pleasure. As I live in North America today, there are many things. You can search the internet, you can read the news, you can look in your local community. Every time you go out into the world, you see many things that are not pleasing to God. Many things. Well, clearly, there are many people that have no idea what does and does not please God. Why is that the case? Number one, they don't read their Bible. Number two, they don't have silent prayer time where they listen humbly in silence, waiting for God to talk to them about their life. And number three, they don't do diligent research and things that God will lead you to do as you genuinely desire him. Okay? It's up to you. It's up to you. This is one of the most amazing thoughts ever. God will always, I repeat, always provide a way for every God seeker to continue to grow in him and prosper despite a world of disobedience. Okay? So be encouraged, okay? Even if you live in the dump of dumps as far as enlightenment is concerned and the people all around you, you can still ask the Lord what he wants you to do. And, you know, he'll tell you exactly, and you can obey your master perfectly day by day and bring pleasure to God, and therefore you get blessed. Okay? Life is pretty simple. I love simple things that just get people. Life is bringing God pleasure. That is what life is. You know how when a husband and wife are married and they actually take their relationship seriously and they recognize the importance and the value that they actually have to ask each other on a regular basis, honey, what am I doing that brings you pleasure? And what am I doing that is a displeasure to you? Okay. Now, seriously. And they talk to each other saying, you know, this is really pleasing to me, this is really displeasing. And they just be honest and raw, and that's how the relationship becomes more pleasurable. Well, that's exactly what you do with God. You get silent in your prayer closet and you say, God, what am I doing in life that's pleasing you? And what is there in my life that is not pleasing you? And, you know, how can I change that? And that's how you work on your relationship. I'm like, it's not hard. It's not hard. It's just God ordained human relationships to be the same. How am I bringing you pleasure? How am I being a displeasure to you? Feedback, conversation. Oh, make changes. But you pleasing God, it just, as I look out on the world today, as I hear people's conversation, like, it's just, people have just totally, it's almost, it's all sheeple. It's all sheeple effect. Oh, because no one else is talking about personal relationship with God in public media and in the newspapers and on TV and in YouTube and in educational arenas and in politics and, you know, my parents don't do it either, and even the churches are barely doing it because no one's talking about, you know, personal relationship with God. Therefore, I guess, well, I'll just talk about humans like everyone else does. It's tragic. It's just sheeple. It's just people always do what they see the most other people doing, and it's very sad. Okay. So talk about your personal relationship with God. I kid you not, the best leader of any group of people anywhere, whether it's a country, politically, whether it's a religious group, a church, okay, there is only one true religion, Jesus Christ. One of the most important things that should come out of that leader's mouth, whether it's the father of a family, whatever, one of the most important things out of that leader's mouth, all day, every day, should be, this is what I believe God is saying to me, personally, right now. And here's why I believe that's what he's saying to me. It's called your personal relationship with God. It's called God talking to you and you knowing his voice. Jesus said, my sheep hear my voice and they follow me. It is the most critical thing. There is nothing more critical for all humans of all ages, all backgrounds, to know the true, all day speaking, personal voice of the true God. Hear it in here. It's not audible. It's in here. Hear it in here, know it, and have the power to obey it. Think about that. If you were flawless, if you were 100% perfect all the time at hearing the constant personal voice of God up here, and he also speaks through your feelings, which is very cool. Sometimes he just makes you feel like doing things. And you, by the grace of God, had the ability to obey the perfect voice of God to you as his, as your master, day and night, flawlessly. That's success for you. And if every human being on planet Earth did that day and night, paradise on Earth. That's it. It's like, think about it. You know how to obey a human master all day long. You know how to take orders from a human voice all day long. Well, now just copy that pattern to hearing the personal voice of God all day long. And now you're on fire. And now miracles are happening. And now, like, yada yada. Okay?